Hey guys, welcome back. I know things have been a little bit crazy. You know, I hope that we could continue to spread love and positivity to your friends, family. So in today's video, I really want to talk about these weird K-pop scams that's been going on pretty much over the internet. There's multiple of them, especially three or four that we're gonna be talking about today. I really want to share a little bit of this with you guys so you can protect yourself whenever you are dealing with things on the internet. So before we get started, I just want to say that I wanted to feel a bit brighter, positive energy, so I've been trying to wear brighter colors because you guys know bright colors actually stimulate the brains and it really just really changes your vibe and overall mood. So wearing this really nice baby blue top. It is really hot here now since it's summer, and also I found this butterfly translucent choker. That even sounds so cool. And then to go along with it, I found this butterfly ear cuff that here you could see the butterfly. So number one, we're gonna be talking about the K-pop idol bank scam. And this is very, very similar to a lot of the spam mails that I get, and you guys probably get too. If you open your spam mailboxes, you're flooded with, you have won $1 million. There's a $1 million fund to your name. Please give us your address, your routing number, blah, blah, blah. I mean, there's a lot of these scams that you get. I'm not sure who falls for them, but apparently people keep on falling for them. So a fan has recently DM'd me saying that she knew this was fake, but it was a little bit fishy. She kind of didn't know, so she went along with it just to see what happens, and then voila. So she recently got a DM from Kim Hyun-jung 873. This person was pretending to be a K-pop idol, Kim Hyun-jung, which he used to be in a group called SS501. It used to be a very famous group, and he's still pretty famous. And basically, they're using the technique of preying on girls that wants to meet these K-pop idols, using techniques to make them feel special and lucky, and that like they're chosen to have a private vacation with them. Hello, thank you very much for being a big fan. I've taken my time to appreciate some of my fans with my private Instagram account, and you are one lucky one. There you go, one lucky one. They make you feel very special. Take care of yourself and stay away from coronavirus. Thank you, much love, Kim Hyun-jung. Thanks for supporting. I don't know if this is real or not, if someone is messing with me, but whoever you are, I hope that you're safe and healthy too. Now, so far, it's pretty safe. Obviously, they're not asking for someone's private information, but they are still catfishing. I don't know if that's the word. Now, obviously, Kim Hyun-jung has an official verified account, so please do not fall for this. If any K-pop idol messages you, number one, look for the verification. Now, some celebrities are still not verified, but you could tell based on their likes compared to their, you know, normal fan pages, so definitely look out. In another day, she received another strange DM from another Kim Hyun-jung account, but this one seemed way, way off. They're using a very similar Instagram ID compared to the real Kim Hyun-jung's ID, so it kind of confuses people, although you should know right away. So this Kim Hyun-jung says, "Hello, thanks for your lovely like and comment on my official page. It's great to know I have such a devoted fan." Yes, you're welcome. Thank you very much for your comment and like, I appreciate that. This is my private account unknown to fan. Cannot use my official page for chatting. It's be managed by my organizations. It's your luck. Really? I don't know if this is a joke, right? Still April Fools. Ha ha ha, don't worry, be happy. I select randomly. You're among the lucky ones I messaged. Ha ha, I got the same message from another account too. So I believe these two accounts are from two different people. It seems like the first account, they were good in English, and all of a sudden, he's bad in English. Also, this account, what they're saying is just inconsistent with the first one, so I think they're two different scammers. Now, somewhere along the way, apparently this fan and Kim Hyun-jung exchanged emails and they started kind of privately chatting. So Kim Hyun-jung says, "This is a management mail. Send them direct mail. Yes, I want to travel. Don't worry. I will make your wish come true. We're going to meet. Okay, when do you think this will happen? Since you're busy, it might take a while, right? Only the management can tell. Many others wish to see me. The faster approach, the earlier we see." So they're actually arranging to meet here. "Okay, do you think they will listen to me? Immediately, you send a direct mail to that, send me a screenshot." So this K-pop idol Kim Hyun-jung has a crush on this fan. It sounds literally like a Wattpad story. No offense, I mean, I love Wattpad stories, I love fan fictions, I know, but come on. Come on. So this fan emails this Kim Hyun-jung manager Gmail account. Now, first of all, red flag, Kim Hyun-jung management account. Like, that's literally the name of this email, which definitely sounds 100% fake. Usually it will say it in Korean Or it will say the company's name or the manager's name, not Kim Young-jun's management. Like, this literally seems like a scammer that is not that bright. Dear Miss Jenny, we contacted Mr. Kim Young-jun and he has confirmed to us that he is aware of a vacation request. Your vacation request? I don't think she requested it at first. And professed to us that you are a special friend. We, the management team, is happy to know you. In regards to the vacation request, Mr. Kim Young-jun is currently having an ongoing project, so therefore the board of directors will have to seat and consider your vacation request. We will get back to you in 48 hours. I've never seen a Korean management refer to anyone as board of directors. That just seems like, it just sounds off. Like, why would a board of director, the whole company, have to approve a private vacation? And why would the K-pop idol even get the approval from the management? It doesn't make sense at all. And look at the email. There's no links. There's no name. There's nothing. Usually scam mails do this. There's no link. There's no phone number. They have no identity because they're using a fake identity. I hope she was just going along with it and didn't really believe it. I really hope so. She says, me too. Oh, I got a reply, and sends a screenshot to Kim Young-jun that she got a reply from the management. Okay, that's very good. They called me and I told them yes. Wow, I didn't think they would reply. I'm so happy. You're welcome. And then she gets this email. This is where shit goes down. Okay, so Kim Young-jun's management emails her and says, Miss Jenny, congratulations. The board of directors has seats and consider your request and your vacations with Mr. Kim Hyun has been granted. You are therefore mandated to pay the sum of $4,575 as the vacation charges which we cover for the hotel accommodations, restaurants, flights, and membership card, among others. What membership card? Is there a membership card in order to hang out with a K-pop idol? And where are they going on a vacation? Where? You are to therefore make the payment into the management financial officer bank account. What does that even mean? Okay, stated below, it says account name Ningzu. The management is some Chinese or some kind of non-Korean name all of a sudden. Bank name, Chase Bank. It's an American bank. Korea doesn't have Chase Bank. Routing number, account number, it's all there. SWIFT code, bank address. It says New York, New York. Home address, Flushing, New York. This person, this scammer, or Kim Young-jun, or whoever this person is in America, not Korea. Ensure to send us a picture of payment received as proof. Thank you. Still again, no name, no link, no signature in the email, nothing. Now obviously, thank God the fan did not send thousands of dollars to this person. Not that any young fan would even have thousands of dollars, first of all. You guys, it's 100% scam. Do not fall for this. At least thank God this fan went all the way to this extent so that she could let us know about this. There would have been someone that is so young and naive who does not know anything about this, who might have fell for this and might have asked their parents to give them thousands of dollars. I mean, I don't even know. Just to let you guys know, I'm sorry to break your fantasies, but a K-pop idol will not message you privately asking for your money, your information. If in 1 in a million chance, if they really like a fan and is DMing you, DM me, please let me know and I'll verify for you. Just kidding. Now this scam actually really got me to think about a very common YouTube influencer scam that is going on right now. Please let your any influencers, YouTubers know about this because some people might fall for it. I get these emails all the time now where there's people that are trying to offer influencers sponsorships on their YouTube channel, telling that they're gonna pay $300, $1,000, $2,000 for it. There is no signature, there's not one link or name to these emails, just like any other scams. But when these scams started going around, I obviously did not know that this was a scam. I replied to them and they sent back like some kind of PDF or link. And apparently if you click on these links, they can steal your information. So do not click on any fishy links or emails. There's a legit YouTube sponsorship coming in, there should be a link, there should be a name, there should be just much more legitimacy than a vague email. So next, let's go into a fishy Korean Instagram account. Now this fan let me know that there are Instagram accounts trying to follow them, you know, follow request them, trying to DM them, and it looked a little bit fishy, and I took a look at them, and yeah, they are definitely a fishy account. Now it will usually look like this, no profile picture. This translated, it says, hiring male, female part-time jobs, a part-time job that is easy and fun. Normal workers, college students, anyone can apply, get paid up front. And it gives them a KakaoTalk ID. KakaoTalk is kind of like WhatsApp for Koreans. And basically these, I am pretty much 99% sure that it is some shady adult part-time jobs. So unless you're interested, which no shade, these could be also very dangerous because you guys have heard about a lot of these scandals. They actually target specifically for young females that are looking for these kind of jobs and later blackmail them, scam them, take their information. So these can be very dangerous. So if there is this account trying to follow you, just block them. There's another example that looks like this. It says meetup. There's an event going on, but this one it says 164.48 cm. I believe this is height, weight, and your size. So 164 centimeters, 48 kilograms, and cm size. Also, this one it was interesting because it says 대비만 부담, which I think this means they're going to pay for the hotel fee. Also, I heard that they promote themselves a lot to foreigners, non-Koreans. It is also easier for them to fall into this because they don't speak Korean that well or English that well, vice versa. So next, we're gonna go into the Twitter fan cam scam that is going on. This is a bit of a triggering, scary one, which I did not know about you guys. But you guys have DM'd me so much to talk about this one. So recently, there has been a group of people that have been using K-pop fan cams on Twitter. These videos all seem normal until a few seconds later into the video, graphic video pops up and it scares you. Now, these videos apparently consist of very violent, disturbing dark web videos. So you do not want to see these, especially these are targeting young kids, underage people who don't know anything about this, and it is messing up teenagers and kids' heads. Now I'm gonna be showing you guys one of the videos, an example. This is not as a disturbing, scary one, but it's basically like a K-pop male idol, and all of a sudden it turns to like a weird, gruesome phase, and the audio, they are cursing on it, things like that, so it is very triggering. A lot of especially young kids and teenagers have said that they lost sleep, they can't go to sleep, and there's been disturbing things in their head. And this is very dangerous because you guys know kids, as being young, you guys are open to a lot of things, and it could put dark images and it could put your emotions into a really dark place. There's also times when they send you direct messages saying what are you afraid of, or just these dark messages, and if you reply, sometimes they're able to get your phone numbers or something like that, and they are just dark trollers. These accounts allegedly have a certain code they go by, so it's kind of like a sign for them. If you see these kind of signs, it usually means that they are part of this dark trolling game. Also, if you guys have Twitter autoplay on, you guys could turn that off in order for you to save you guys. It is also said that it's not just K-pop videos anymore. They have migrated, or now they're using a lot of just regular pop videos like Ariana Grande videos and for examples like that. I'm not really sure, but I hope that by now at least Twitter and some other social media platforms know that this thing is going on. They're able to stop a lot of these. Try not to go on these platforms specifically that are targeting these things. Just clear yourself and be out of this section of the internet until everything is okay. Do not let these things get inside your head for too long. You guys are strong. We are brave. And thank you guys so much for submitting this to me so we could talk about it and let the word out there. Leave a comment down below what you guys have thought about all of this, if you guys have experienced these. Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell because I reply to all my early birds. Yes, if you're early, I reply to your comment. Thank you guys. Stay safe, stay brave, stay positive, and have a magical day.